So thanks for joining this session about SEBLOD. First, I'm just going to present SEBLOD and the company, which is behind. So SEBLOD is developed by Octopus, which is a French web agency. Okay, and the first version of SEBLOD was released in 2009. And so it has been enhanced. And now we have a really mature release, so which is compatible with the latest version of Joomla, the 3.3. In the company, we are less than 10%. We have designers, developers, and commercial. And so we develop SEBLOD, and on the other side, we are an agency, so we have clients almost everywhere. About SEBLOD, so first, who already used SEBLOD? SEBLOD, who knows it? Okay. So, is it okay for you?
Oh, maybe that's it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's.
I try to stay like this. Okay, so SEBLOD is what we call a CCK. So for Joomla, there are more and more CCKs. We the K2. There is Zoo from Youth.
Okay.
Yeah, you want me to speak? That's it. Okay. So what a CCK does, in our case, for Joomla, we extend the basic Joomla article, we extend categories, and we extend the users, okay, with extra fields. And in this case, for this session, what we're going to do is to create a basic SEBLOD content type, okay, based on Joomla article. Okay, so directly to the subject. What I've prepared is a website talking about color, okay, the city. I've grabbed some information from the official website, colon.d, there, go home, okay, this one. So the idea here is to create a specific content type for news for this website, okay? So we could do it through basic Joomla content. We're going to add some extra fields to this news, okay, to after be able to perform some queries, some and so to have specific news displayed. Okay. As you can see on the so the basic Joomla website with the basic template. On the background, you can see some pictures of bedding, some pictures of column. It's SEBLOD stuff. It's a SEBLOD application. Which I just grabbed from the market of the SEBLOD website and installed on the website. There are behind this specific content type where I just set the title and image, and after there is a search which is used to display the specific images behind. Okay, I'll talk about this after, but it's just to show you that from SEBLOD you can grab application. You just have to install them. You enter your content, and it's working with a little bit of configuration. Same for Get In Touch. So I've already installed a form for this website. This form is based on a SEBLOD content type, okay, which is called feedback, okay, where you have different fields, first name, last name, email, and everything. And you have a submit button. And when you do this, in fact, you create a content in Joomla, which is basically an article, okay, but with extra fields. Okay, so it's stored as an article in Joomla, but you have extra information, okay? And what it does when you submit, so it's stored the information, plus you have a hidden field which gets the email you've entered. You receive an email, confirmation of your submission, and an administrator receives also an email with this information, so to contact you or to manage your request. Okay. But basically, here it's really a simple SEBLOD form. Okay, and again, it's an application. I've grabbed from the market of the SEBLOD website. I've just installed it, and I already had the content form created. The menu item to display this form, and the menu item sorry, to manage this form. So we'll see this in the session just after this one. I'll talk about how to manage content from the front end. Okay. So first, in fact, the two sessions are slightly linked. So I'm going to create the content form in this session, and in the next one, we'll be able to manage the content that is submitted from the front end. Okay. So now what we're going to do is going in the back end of the website, create a basic content form to manage the news for this website. Okay. You can hear me correctly? It's okay. If you have questions, of course, don't hesitate if I'm too fast. I'm already logged in on the backend. Maybe I'm going to be disconnected. So SEBLOD is installed. So when it's installed, you have an extra menu item there, which is called construction. Okay, it's a drop down where you have, in fact, all the stuff of SEBLOD. So just to describe quickly, app folder is a way to organize your stuff, and if it's well organized, you'll be able to extract the whole folder that you will be able to call. It will be an application, and you will be able to install this application on another website, and you will get everything you've done for this application, the fields and everything. You have the form and content type, so this is where we're going to work the, for this session. It's we're going to create the form. The field is a list of fields available on the website. So of course you can create your own fields. List and search types is to create some searches, so based on a database query, to extract from database specific content and display them on the front end or back end. And templates, SEBLOD uses its own internal templates, which are based on the Joomla template structure. Okay. And so you can create your own templates, like a blog template or a slider template, or everything that you want, everything you want. Okay. And sites, because SEBLOD, with SEBLOD, you can manage multi-sites on the same website, based on a domain name or an IP address or an alias. So in fact, you can have two different addresses going directly to the same Joomla website, and based on access levels of Joomla, you can say, okay, this if this is this URL, okay, this is this content type display. So you can have a different template, different menu items, different content displayed. It's the same website, but on one end you have two, three, four websites, but it's they are managed at the same place on the Joomla backend. Okay. So forms and content types. Yeah. Okay. Forms and content type. So from here, basically when you install SEBLOD, you already have some created content types. OK, okay because we already override the articles, the categories, and the users. So these three are already there, and the user groups. As I installed applications, I've mentioned just before, we now have extra content types like background, feedback for the form, and places. We'll do this after if we have time. So I'm going to create a new one. So from here, I click on the new button. And I have a choice of which kind of content I want to create. Is it, will it be an article, a category, a user, or a user group? Here, in fact, depending on what you choose, you're going to extend your content will be stored either. It will be linked to an article of Joomla, a category, a user, or a user group. Okay, this means you can create a content type based on the user. Okay, and add fields to this content type on the front end. Display the form, and in fact, when the user will submit it, it will create a user in Joomla, in fact, with specific fields. Okay, but here we want to create an article, and we also can choose to create a blank form, so without any standard fields in it. So here we're going to base our work on article. I think I can extend this. Yes. Okay. So as I've chosen article, I've already some fields filled in my form. Okay. I'm going to explain this view. Okay, so you have to set a title for your content type, at least it's a mandatory field. Okay. On the right, you have the app folder where you have to choose where you want to store your content type. It, in fact, it's a way to organize your stuff. Okay. By default, you have a quick folder where if you don't need to organize it, you put it in the quick folder. Okay. You have some tabs. You have two kind of tabs. You have what we call the views tabs and the options tabs. So for view, you have specific tabs on the right. Okay, so for admin form, if you click on template and you are admin form, you will have template options of the admin form. Okay, you just have configuration, which is a global tab, so which applies to the content type. Okay, no matter the tab you are there. Okay. So by default, we're in admin form and fields. This means we're going to fill, we're going to add fields to the admin form. Okay. We have information there. So the object, the Joomla object linked to this content type. So this article, you can manage permissions for this content type. This means who can create, who can edit, who can delete. Okay. So it's Joomla permissions. Okay, so if I open it, I will. No, for this one, it's this is a global. These are global options. Okay, so. Oh, this yes, yeah, and form yes means yeah means backend. Okay, it, when you're going to when we're going to click on no, please. Happen. Yes. Okay, it's back. In fact, when you're going to the content manager and you're going to click on the new button, you'll see you will have to choose what kind of content you're going to create until you have this one available. Okay. So permissions. So Joomla group. Okay. Default. Public cannot create okay this form, but you can allow it for a contact form. Okay, you have to allow public to create because maybe you don't have to be logged in on the front end to create a contact form. Okay, so by default these are these permissions, and so like so it's for public, but if I check for users, so everyone, so all permissions, administrator, manager, they are allowed. So you have some permissions like edit own. So you can choose, okay, if the creator, so the created by information is a currently logged user, can he edit its own content? So you can separate these two things. Same for date, okay? And you can also choose to set limit of content created by your user, okay? There, you can say, okay, a user can only create 10 content, okay? So these are for permissions. So from I'm going to keep these tabs. Okay. We're in the admin form. I'm going to just check the template tab. Okay. By default, there is the template, the SEBLOD template for the admin form is called SEB1. Okay. I have different things. We have two. So we have templates for forms and for content. Okay, and we have templates which you have for list. Okay, because one template for the form and content, you only display one content, and the list can display more than one. So the templates are different. So here by default, SEB1 is the default template for forms and content. Okay. You can have more available on the market. There are some are free, some are commercial. Okay, but these two ones are free. Okay. So depending on which template you have, the positions available in the admin form are different. Okay. This is why I wanted to show you this. And you have options for the template. You can decide to show the description of the form, labels, sorry, of the fields. Okay, you have a section for fields. You can decide to show label and description of the field. You can override some CSS stuff, margins, and so on. Okay, you can try to hide some columns, some, and you can override some variations. I'm not going to explain this too deep because we don't have much time. But from here, so as we were in the form, you everything here is to customize the form. Okay, so I'd like to fit. You can see so from here, these are the positions available on the template. We have a main body, top body, and if you don't know where these positions will be displayed, you have a positions button at the top. Okay, so for step one, that should be the name of this one, but yeah, that's weird. I have to check, but so you have main body, top body, bottom body, side by A, side by B, you have all the right, left, well, top, no, header, top, bottom, footer, so A, B, C, D, E, F. So depending on where you put your fields, the position will be displayed on, okay? So we just have for now five fields in my body, the title, alias, category, state, and access. So for now, we're just going to keep it like this. And I'm just going to save it and see what happens. But maybe I'll be disconnected. So I just need to here to enter a name for my content type, okay? So news. And here, I'm going to put it in quick folder, okay? I just save. Okay, it's successfully saved. I'm just going to open a new tab. let's go there in fonts and content type. So to check, okay, so it's open. I've got my news content type with only five fields in the admin form. Okay, so here you have information about the number of fields configured in every views, but this is also a shortcut. So if I click here on five, I'm directly in the admin form view. Okay. So if I take another one, like a category, and I click on content, I'm directly in the content tab. Okay, so it's shortcut. If you know already what you're going to work, what you want to check, so you just can click on the number. So I'm going to Article Manager. So as you can see, what I mentioned just before, history of columns, so is an article, and as you can see, you would have three background articles, which are in fact the background you can see on the front end of the template. Okay. I click on the new button, and so usually when SEBLOD is not installed, you're directly in the article form Joomla. Okay. There you have to choose which content type you're going to create. So the basic article. Content type, the background, and the place, so but we'll see this after. So background, you create a background for your template. And here we're going to create a news content type, okay? And we have the five fields we've seen here, okay? So I can just enter, news like this one. I can choose the category, okay, the status, and the access for my news. Now I leave it to uncategorized. I leave it like this. I save. And my article is displayed in the content manager as a standard article for Joomla. But clicking on this, okay, you can see the. No, you cannot see. But the URL is not the. URL of the content of Joomla. Okay, you're directly. I've clicked. Yes. No. Yes. You can see the URL. You're in SEBLOD. Okay. You're not in Joomla anymore. You're in .com.ckk. So it's really the form of SEBLOD. So now what we're going to do is we're going to organize this form much better. Like. We're going to create some news, so maybe we don't have to choose the category. We're going to force the category of all news articles to be stored in a news category, okay? So I'm going to create here a category. So again, you can extend categories in Joomla. So for now, we just have one. So I'm just creating a category. News category, and it will be so at the top. It's not a problem. Okay, so I have now my news category. I go back to my form, and in fact here I'm going to force the category to be news. Okay, so there are many ways to do this. Here we have extra tabs, okay? These are tabs, and you can choose which information you want to display there, okay? So by default, we have a label and variation. So this means here, we change the label which is displayed for the field on the left, okay? And you choose a variation. Clearly, a variation is the HTML code which is going to be the container, in fact, of the field. Okay. You can change it for a position or for a field. Okay. You have some available. And so by default, if it's a text field, so it will be an input tip text and everything with some divs, one, two divs around it, okay? If I click on the two view, on the number two, here you can see the information has been changed. This means when you're going to open a form and the value is not filled, so on creation, for example, you can choose how the field is going to be filled. So which value is going to be displayed in the field. And by default, in fact, here you can enter this value. Okay, so if you want every time you create a news, you want the title filled by news, just type news here, and when you're going to create a new news, the title will already be filled with news. After, you can change it, of course. And for us, the important thing is we want the category to be news. Okay, so 16 is the ID of the category. Okay, and you can also force the state and the access of this news. Okay, so if I save here and I go back to my content manager, my article manager, I create a new news. You can see the category is already set with news. Okay. Only for new content, not for the existing content. If you created a content with the title so Joomla Day and I change the default value to be news, my content previous content will not be updated. Okay. And if it's only if it's not filled. Okay. I'm going to, so it's going to be faster now because I don't have to choose the category. Okay, and the alias, maybe it's useless. The status, I can keep it, but the access, it's a public website, so everything will be public. Okay, so what I can do now is, I don't want it to be changed, so I don't want to display it, but I still want it to be on the form, okay, but not displayed. So that I don't want the user to change this information. I need it because when I'm going to submit the form, I need these values to be in the submission, okay? But I don't want them to be displayed. So we have a position called hidden. In fact, it will be in a div that will not be displayed for the user, okay? So I'm going to move the field I want in it. So you can drag and drop, okay? So first, so move it to the hidden position. So you can see hidden is at the bottom of the list of positions, okay? But because it's empty, if I save, it's going to be now up because it's filled. Okay? So you already have your positions with fields in them, okay? So it's after you have a direct access to it. So I'm going to move access and category to this position and only keep these three ones available for the user, okay? And maybe alias. Well, I can keep alias, okay. I save. If I refresh this one, okay. I have title, alias, and status. I can change it. So I'm going to, so there is marathon on Sunday, if I'm right. I save and close, and you can see that it's in use and access is public. Okay. So you just with this, you need only fill the fields which are important for you. Okay. So it's faster. We have worked on fields already there when we have created our content. Now maybe we need an extra field for our news, like which type of news it is. So is it a technical news, a sport news, or something else? So we're going to create a specific field for this. On the right, you have the list of available fields. Okay, you can filter. Here you have the folders available for SEBLOD. So all the folders that are already created when you install SEBLOD. So, and you can see if I'm going in Joomla article, I have fields, because I already did that. Okay. I have fields about an article. So I can add other things. I can add article ID if I want, intro text. So if you want a description for the news, that would be cool. So I'm going just drag and drop, okay? Just maybe after the title. So we're going to have an intro text now, full text. What could we add after? So I added two fields, okay, and now I'm going to create a new one, which will be a select list, a drop down with a list of type of news, okay. I click on the plus button, which is there. And again, I have to choose a title for my field, an app folder. So quick folder. So this means if I, before this, if I I had created a news folder and I have put my content type in it and all my fields in it, after I will be able to export this folder as an application and go on another website where SEBLOD is installed, import this application, well, install it through the extension manager of Joomla, and I would have the content type, the folder, all the fields, everything would be automatically set. Okay, and with the same permissions, with everything the same. So if you can create your own news application and export it and install it on another website with the same configuration. Okay, so I'm going to create a field which is news type. I leave it in quick folder, the name, so it's going to be automatically filled. Okay, there is a check. Okay, so it's checking if the name is available, because the name is an internal value for SEBLOD to manage on the stuff. So it's available, so it's okay. And here what's important, of course, it's what kind of field I want to create. The basic one is an input text, okay, but we have a lot of fields. And these fields are based on plugins, so this means you can extend SEBLOD with your own fields. You have fields for even a button is a field. Okay, you can create a field which is a button for your form. You instead and call it what you want. So submit my subscription or what you want. Okay. You have free text. So if you just a field which displays string, okay, or HTML content. You have links. Of course, you have for form. So you have checkboxes and everything. You can create tabs. Divs, so if you want to create a specific container, so it's a HTML div, okay, and you can add classes to it. So in fact, you can create divs and add some bootstrap CSS bootstrap classes, okay. If you want to create specific dropdowns or things like this, you can do it through this field. We have so all the Joomla library GForm, so access levels, the categories. We have calendars, everything, okay. And for the select, which we're going to use, we have four kind of selects. We have a dynamic, so this means you can, instead of having to fill all the options, the select, it's the dynamic. You can say, okay, I already have my values in a table. Okay, so you always have this value on all the fields, so it's the label of the field, which can be different of the title. You have default value, and here you can say, okay, I'm going to, in this case, okay, I'm going to grab information from the content table. You have to select which column of the table is going to be used as the option name, which is going to be used as the value. You have where for your query, so if you want to filter it, you have a not by, and that's almost all. And of course, the important thing, the storage of the field. So where the value of this field is going to be stored. If you create the field by default, if you create the field directly from a form, okay, this is the configuration of the field, of the storage. Okay, so it's standard article because it's based on an article. And here you have to fill a value. And in fact, what it's going to do, it's going to create a specific table in the database, if it doesn't already exist, okay, based on the name of your form. Okay, so here it's news. So the table will be CCK store form news. And you're going to have a column. Then the name of the column will be the name you're going to fill here. Okay. So as soon as you add fields which are not stored Joomla article fields, they're going to be added in a specific table. Okay. Why this? Because it's better for the queries. Okay. It's better to for the searches to retrieve views. Okay. And so it's good because we have import and export tools. So when you want to import a huge amount of content for on your website, we have an importer. So you create a CSV, the correct columns, and this will be automatically created when you're going to import. Okay. So this never changes, and the above section neither. So what's changing is the construction section, depending on which type of field you you select. Okay. So still on dynamic, instead of construction, I select free, and here you type directly your query. Okay, so you can join two, three tables, you can do what you want. Okay. And the result, the result will be displayed as a select. Okay, with values and names, and the value you're going to choose will be stored in a table. So you can see we also can use the language detection. Honestly, I don't remember, but if you can suffix your column with an underscore and the code of the language, and depending on the language of the user, the specific field, the specific column of the table will be grabbed. Okay. And we have custom attributes, but it's much too long to explain what it does. You can attribute in the option where you select option. You can attribute. This means like in jQuery, you know, data dash and your attribute. So you can add specific attributes if after you want to work with some jQuery stuff on your select list. Okay. For now, what we're going to use. So it's not dynamic. I've explained it. So you have multiple numeric. Let's say you have a list. You want to have a field with and you ask the user to hit birth year. Okay, you can say okay birth year, and it will start from 1974 or maybe before 60. Okay, it's a sum. So step one and 2004. Okay, so here you will have a list of, so it will start at 1960, 1961 to 2014. Okay, but it can be a sum, it can be a product, it can be a difference or a quotient. And if I say here step 10, it will be like this. So you have 1960, 70, 80, and on until 10. Okay, but now we're going to just use the simple one. I set a label for the field, okay, type, because I will be in the news form, so I know I'm going to create a news, so I don't need to set news type here, okay. I know what kind of content I work on, so default value here, I have it empty. I will have a selection option, okay, by default. And here, okay, so let's say technical support. Again, politics and financial, okay, and touristic maybe. Touristic, yeah. Is it an English word, touristic? Yeah. Yeah. Thank you. Okay. Tourism, yes. Thanks. Okay. So the ordering of my options by default, so it's following option. So it will be technical support like this. So if I follow the option, I can move them, okay, the way I want, but I'm going to display them alphabetically. And so the storage, it will be my column in my table will be type. Okay. I save and close. I hope I'm not disconnected. Okay. It's created automatically. It's added to my main body position because it was selected here. You see there are radio buttons there, so you can say, okay, I'm working on the main body position, but I can also do this, working on the hidden position, and say I want to have this one, okay. I can do this if I want, so, but I'm going to remove them. Okay, we have the news type, and I'm going to move it maybe just after the title. I save. And now I'm not going to create a news. I'm going to edit one of the two created, like D. Okay, so see the title is still there. Option, so it's empty because the field is not there when I've created it first. I now have an intro text with a WYSIWYG. Okay. I have a full text and I have alias, which so has been automatically created, and the status. Okay. So I just need here to say, okay, Joomla Day, technical, intro text. Come to join us. Okay. And of course, so you have all the benefits of the Joomla editor. Okay, you can still add image. Okay, you can do what you want in it. So by default, it's my editor, okay, but it can be JTE or another one. I save and close. I'm going to do the same for the marathon. So I just say it's a sport news. It's on Sunday and join us. Saving those. I've got my two news. Okay. Just after. So I've got them. Now I need to display them on the front. Okay, because now if I go back to the page, I have nothing. So what I'm going to do is to move this page on another menu item. I am going to call it history and change the home page to display the news from here. So menu, main menu. Okay. I get an item called news. And I'm going to create a view articles, a category blog, okay, a basic one. choose a category, I'm going to choose news. That's all. It will be on the root. Okay, and I'm going to set it as a default page. Okay, and new. So I've got news. Okay, I'm going to move it first, and I'm going to change the name of this one in history. Okay, I just have one because I just see that the other one has not been changed. Yeah. So we can see it's uncategorized. So what I need to do there, yes, I'm just going to see, okay, you need to do this. So I'm just moving category available. I go there and here. So move to news. Okay, I've got the titles. So I've created a Joomla category view. Okay, so it retrieves the Joomla articles. Okay, because I've written a title. So it's really when I'm there, I'm going to open it. Okay, it was an existing field, and you can see here standard article title, and in fact. As title is a basic column in the content table, okay, it's going to store it in the content table. If it's not part of the column existing, which already exists in the content table, it's going to create the extra table. So that's why my type is in an extra table. But here you have the list of all the columns of the content table. Okay, so as soon as you use of them, it's going to be stored in content. Okay, so in fact, you can create. I could have created another field, which could be a select list. If I set the field to be stored in standard article title, it will store it as a Joomla title. Okay. So for you, for this title, I could have, create another field. So if you want to limit the title to a list, I don't know, of 10 titles, you know, so you can create a select list or you can do what you want. Okay. And, this means you can also, you can of course have one field for your backend and another field for your front end. Okay, which can be a different type or can have a different configuration, but will still store the information at the same pace. Okay. This is, for me, it's a more powerful feature of SEBLOD when you really start to work with it, because you're not stuck with a text field for the title. Select for the category. Okay, you can choose what kind of field you want for your title, for your for what you want. In fact, you can have for category it can be a text field for intro text. It can be a select field for it's really flexible. Okay. So I save nothing, so I just cancel everything. So this means for your intro text, a good a feature which is often used is on the admin form, your article intro text use the default one, so it will be a WYSIWYG. But maybe on the front, you don't want the user to add HTML code and everything, so you can say, okay, I'm going to create an extra field for my front-end form, and in fact, this would be a text area. So the user won't have access to any HTML, so we will just be able to enter text, and that's all. You have the end on the back-end with HTML, but on the front-end, the user will only be able to add some text. That's all. Okay. So this can be done through this storage feature. Okay. 5 minutes. Okay. So we've created the form. I'm just going to show you. So for now, just see the title here. Okay. What could be great is to display at least the intro text. Okay. So I go back there. I mean forms and form. Okay. You see the difference. Intro and content. In fact, intro is what's going to be displayed when you're in a category view, like this one. And content, what's going to display when you have the full details of the article. Okay. And intro, you see, we display nothing. The title, it's the basic stuff of Joomla. Okay, it displays the title. So now, here, what we need to do is to add some information here for the intro. So we're going to add the news type. Okay. And we're going to add the intro text. So it's in base, if I remember. Yes. Okay. Save. I refresh. Okay. Open the type intro text. You have sport, content, you have both of them. Let's say the label. So I'm in the intro, so you can change the label there if you want. Okay. You can change the order and everything. A good feature also is on view 4. You can choose which group, the access level. So if the user group of the current logged in user has access, you can see it. So I just want the type or the intro text, you know, to be viewable by super users. Do this and save. There, I'm not logged in. I log in there. Okay. So you can manage permissions easily. Okay. We've managed intro view. Now we have to manage the content view. Same again. New type. Where was it? So, and we're going to show the full text. Yes, we're going to display intro text again. And maybe, what could we display? The creation. Yeah, so it's in publishing. So created by, so it will be the super users and the created. Save, go back to news. Oh, I know. I've removed the link from the content. Okay, so we now have the link. And we're in the article. Okay, so we have. And so there, what could be good is to remove this, maybe for the type, but remove the labels if you want. Okay, so you have the possibility to do this. I go back to, so yeah, so back to my form, new. So directly here I want to work on the content, so I click on 5 and I'm there. Yeah, a little, so instead of intro text level, as soon as I set the label to be clear, okay. If it's clear like this. Label won't be this. Okay. After, of course, it needs some CSS. And what you could do is to move these things in another position to have something. So maybe all the publishing information could display on the body. So I move them here. Sorry. Finish. Okay, with a little bit of, again, some CSS, but well, you have the idea. Okay, and so you can display fields that are not in the form, okay? And they are automatically filled by Joomla when you say, but if you want to display them on the content or maybe on the intro, of course, these fields can be displayed in the form, on the admin form, if you want to override created by user and the created date, you can do this. And you also have fields of fields, which in fact call them group. I go back to admin form. I want to display everything, and I want group fields. We have article group publishing. I'm going to show this in the sideboard. If I go back to Marathon of Cologne, sideboard is removed. But I just added one field, and I've got this. Okay, you can say okay. I have a group of fields I always use. Okay. That is the case, and okay, I put them in a group, and I only add the group to the form, and you have on this, and so this field is reusable on the forms, and you can create of course your own groups, and we also have what we call a group X, where you have one field, and you have the like I had in the when I've created the select simple, you have plus minus button where you can duplicate clone in fact the group and add for a form like maybe an image. You want to add several images for a content, you have the plus minus and say okay, I have an image, I want to add another one, and you will have an upload for an example. Okay. It's time. Is it clear for you? Maybe I've been too fast. You have questions? No? Okay. Well. Okay, so it's just time. Okay. Yeah, sure. Like we have to avoid this, we have a field which is called canonical URLs, and in fact on the field you can use this to, and in fact it adds in the header, in the head of the page for the content, you can have canonical URL of the content, so for Google it checks, and if you can have a content displayed on three or four different URLs, as soon as you use this field, Google will see, okay, it's a different URL, but the canonical one is this one. Okay, so it's to inform Google that it's not the same URL, but it's this one, which is in fact the source, the canonical one. You can create a custom field that adds this information in the head, of course. Yes. Yeah. Because you have a field that, in fact, you said, okay, it's just PHP code. You say, okay, this field will execute this PHP code before rendering the content, or after rendering, or after saving, before saving the content. So You can have your custom code for this. Yes. Sorry. Yes. You can add classes to the global template, the global view, and to for each field. Yeah, I can show this. Sure. Yes, here. So let's say in content, okay. You have three there. Okay, so markup class. Let's say for a class that will change news type. My class, I save. I go back here. I was in the content. Content, I refresh HTML. News. Where is this one? My class. Okay, and so you can do this for a field or can you close, please? You can do it. So in the content, I go to template. So here, the template configuration of the content, okay? Still the same template because it only displays one information, which is the content. But here you have a root class, okay? So it will be in the main container of the view. So you can add one there. And after, you can work on all your fields depending on this one. Okay. Yes?
I have a question about the storage.
Yes?
When I create a PX or UPX field or non-exclusive field, standard suggests always custom
art, yes.
Intro text.
Yes.
Is intro text optional or can I use a rule I have?
You can intro text is optional by the if you yes if you set custom articles by default it will be an intro text, and if you fill a value it will be in intro text but with a specific tag. Yeah, but for GroupX and FieldX it's much safe to keep custom article. I don't remember if intro text is written when you set it. I think intro text is written.
Always,
yes.
Always the
yeah.
And also keep it. Non-exclusive
fields. Yes. Yeah. But this is something we have to work on. To in fact, even FieldX and GroupX would like to have them in a standard way of storage. This means one line per information, because for the search, for the queries, it's much better. Okay, no more questions. So just need some water. Okay. You're ready for the next session? That's it? You already record for the next session or no? Just 1 minute.